You're welcome again to Regina Pashi's online teaching on English language for JSS3. I am Ms. Oyemechi Ogui. This day we're going to be looking at a fresh topic, which is letter writing. Letter writing. Now, before we do this, we want to look at the specific objective why we want to study this particular topic today. We said at the end of the lesson, the student should be able to, number one, define a letter. We make use of letters every day, but the majority of us will not be able to define a letter. The second objective there is to identify the types of letters that we have and be able to differentiate between them. And then the last objective there is to state the structure of the formal letter. Each letter has its own structure. It has its own pattern. It has its own features of writing these letters. Now, what is letter or what is a letter? We say a letter is a written message conveyed from one person to another person. A written message. It is not done orally. It is not done verbally. It must be written. Now, when you convey such message from your own to another person, we call that letter. Now, letter could be written or printed. That means it could be handwritten or it could be printed as in type and then sent to whomever you want to send it to. Now, we look at the types of letter that we have. For this class, we're going to limit ourselves to these two types of letters. We're going to be looking at the formal letter and also the informal letter. Now, what do we mean by the formal letter? We said that the formal letters are those letters addressed to offices of people in positions of authority. Now, they are not just the kind of letter you write to everybody you see on the way. Formal letters are specifically addressed to offices or people in positions of authority. You can talk about the manager in the company. You can talk about the commissioner of police. You can talk about the head of a school. Example, these are people that are in positions of authority. Now, when we talk about formal letters, those people we are writing to, we are not familiar with the people to whom formal letters are written to. That means we do not have a personal relationship with these people. We do not know most of them one-on-one. That is why we say they are formal letters. We are not familiar with the people we are writing it to. And then, these formal letters are written. When writing formal letters, we should avoid playful words. This is a very serious type of letter. We do not use playful words. We do not use the four-word slang like the what's up, how are you doing, all those kind of words. We do not make use of them in the formal letter. The formal letter is a strict type of letter. You go straight to the point. You do not have the time to exchange pleasantries with anybody or with whomever you are writing to because you do not know this person. And there is no time for you to exchange such pleasantries or greetings. Now, formal letters are also called official or business letters. Now, we move over to the features of formal letters. Remember, I said here that every letter has its own features, it has its own format, it has its own ways of writing such letters. Now, under this, we have six features of the formal letter. The first one we have here is the address. Every letter has its address. But for the formal letter, we have two addresses. That means the writer's address and the receiver's address. Now, who is the writer? The writer is the person who is writing the letter. And then when we talk about the receiver is the person to whom the letter is written to. That is why we say that a formal letter has two addresses. Now, the writer's address is always written on the right-hand top side of the paper, and immediately after the writer's address, you have the receiver's address, which comes on the left-hand side, immediately after the writer's address. address. The next thing that follows this address is the letter. Now, in the formal letter, everything needs to be official and business line. By today's date, we have 1st of June 2020. So when I'm writing my date, I will also make use of this 2020. I will not want to write this and put 20. This is not formal. This is wrong. But this is the correct way to put in your date when you are writing. And this date comes under the receiver, under the writer's address. The receiver's address does not carry any date. The date under the writer's address covers for both the receiver and the writer. Then the next thing we have here is the salutation. When we talk about the salutation, we're not talking about greeting. Greeting is how are you, how is your family, how is work. We want to look at salutation. How do we greet those people? We have on the board here, sir or ma'am. Now, what we have here, or why I put this here, is to show you that because we do not know the people we are writing to, we might not know if they are male or female. And because we do not know their gender, that is why we want to use dear sir or ma'am. So that when you have a man as the receiver, the sir will go for it. And if it's a woman, the man will also be appropriate. That is why we use dear sir or ma'am. But when at venture, you know the gender, the person you are writing to, and you know that this person is a man or a woman, that is why we now make use of the appropriate salutation. So if it is a man, I have dear sir, and I will not include the man there. That is for the salutation. And this salutation comes immediately after the receiver's address. And then it is followed by a comma to show that you are done with that salutation. Now the next thing that follows is the title of the letter. Every formal letter has a title. Every formal letter should have a heading. There is always a reason why you are writing that letter. And that letter will be seen, the purpose of the letter will be seen immediately from the title of the letter. So when you have your letter, after the salutation, on the next line, you have the title. Now there are two methods in writing the title of the formal letter. When you write the block letter, you do not underline, but when you use your small letter, you must underline straight rulings. For example, I have letter of application. I have this letter of application. I will not underline this because I have written in capital letter. Therefore, this is okay. But if I do this, letter of application, I must underline this because I have not written with capital letters. And then you underline and the title is there. Every title should be linked to the purpose of the letter. If you are not applying for a job, there is no need for you to write letter of application. If you are writing a letter of request or complaint, you do not write letter of application. You use the correct heading for each letter you are writing. Now, immediately after the title of the letter, what follows is the body of the letter. Now, we are told that every letter should begin with paragraph. At least we should have 2 to 3 paragraphs before our letter will be good. Remember that because this is a formal letter, it has to be very short. We do not write this formal letter and lengthen it the way we would write our informal letter with 3-4 pages. Because whoever that is reading this might not have the time to go through all you have written. Therefore, you must go straight to the point. Now, assuming I am applying for a job now, let's continue with this example. The first paragraph of my letter should be able to bear everything about me. I should be able to talk about myself, what are my qualifications, what my name is, where I come from, the kind of things I do, and my area of specialization, because I am applying for a job. Now, it's also appropriate for you to let also explain other activities that you do aside the thing that will make your employee to have the heart of admitting you or employing you into the organization. Then the last one is just the closure. You use it to appreciate them, thanking you in anticipation because you feel you've already gotten the job. Now the last of the formal letter, the last feature of the formal letter, we have what we call the closing, or we have what we call the subscription. Now this is where you end your letter, and for every formal letter, what you have is yours faithfully, and it is written this way with a comma. Your why should be written in capital letter. There should be no apostrophe before the S. This is yours. Yours without an apostrophe. And then we have the faithfully. You have your comma. What follows next is your signature. Your signature comes here. And after your signature, you have your full name on that display. Your full name should be there. And it is also advisable to state your mobile number, because we know that we are in the jet age. When letters are being replied, a lot of organizations, a lot of companies no longer write back to you. They make it of the number that you have on your letter to get back to you, maybe to invite you for an interview or to tell you that you have been employed for the position you are looking for. So you end by yours faithfully, your signature, your full name, and then your mobile number. Now, the assignment is on the board. The explanation of formal letter, write the letter of application, and it should be submitted to our group assignment page. Not later than 12 a.m. today. Thank you.